Josh, and I'm throwing this party, and I want you to be at it. And he said, that sounds like something I'd be very interested in. And so we're grateful that you've come down from San Francisco. After just getting off the plane from a trip in Europe, so we mentioned a little jet lag, but we're glad that you're here. I'm not going to go through, as I mentioned to him, his entire background, because it's an extensive background to get into where he is today. I will let you speak more about that. But if, for those who don't know, DJI is still selling, I keep hearing, between 70 and 80% of the drones in the industry. I'm sure it's somewhere in the middle there. He'll talk more about it. They were one of the front runners. They've been around for 10 years. They just celebrated the 10th year anniversary. And in a very short period of time, it developed an incredible company that's revolutionized how people are gathering video content, photography, and I think you'll talk a lot about the thermal cameras and thermal technology that you guys are part of with FLIR. So without further ado, I'm going to bring up Romeo Durscher.
Yeah, Josh said there's going to be a party, and I expect all right, it's going to be a party. We'll make it fun. I'm really delighted to be here. This is really cool because this is all about education. And so as such, we're going to be talking a few different things. And in fact, I had a hard time figuring out what exactly I want to present today because this is in a completely different environment. We have a lot of educators in here. And as educators, you are the ones that are very well educated already. And so I don't need to talk too much about certain things. So you're also the ones that inspire the next generation. So I can't really go into, you know, my inspiring pep talk too much. So I have to kind of figure out my way around all of this. So I decided I'm just going to throw a little bit of everything into this morning's talk. And if you have any questions, they have an answer for you, and if not, my standard answer is soon. So, if you want to know when something will be released, soon. Alright, let's get started. As Josh mentioned, my name is Romeo Durscher. You may have detected an accent. I was born and raised in South Chicago. never works. Born and raised in Switzerland, actually. Over from Europe and came in 97 to the United States because I wanted to work for NASA. I wanted to work on a space mission. And Switzerland does great stuff with watches and chocolates and banks, but they don't do much space stuff. And so I decided I have to move, and I came to California, and I got to work for NASA. And this is a beautiful picture taken from a space station of your area. Without any clouds and smog, how often does that happen? I spent 13 years at NASA, and NASA was really great to do STEM outreach, science, technology, engineering, and math. But there was always a component missing. And now at DJI, I can really add that particular component, and that's A for arts. It's really now STEAM education, because we need to include the A for arts, because so many students are not interested in technology or are afraid of engineering, but they have the artistic side to them, and we need to include them in our educational plan. So it's STEAM education now for me, and I'm really happy that I can do that for DJI. A little bit about my background. This is actually my first drone that I ever took, and I'm not kidding, it's exactly today, 3 years ago. I looked it up, so I was in Phoenix, Arizona for the first time. I took a drone of myself, and I thought, oh, that was pretty cool. But then I also realized if you do it right, you really get a completely different perspective. And so here a friend of mine and I are standing on top of a cliff, and there was this huge wave, and I was just completely blown away by the way we can see several images from one location in the air and then putting them together to an aerial panorama. And that's how my love for drones really started. Now, if you believe the media, I have done it all. Somehow, an image of mine that the AP took ended up in the database, and every time there is a drone story, they take that image and use it. So in this case, German court throws up case by family of slain Yemenis. There is me flying in its picture. Drone knocks on unconscious at Seattle. I have really done it all. Drone attack survivors take their story to Washington. Seriously, I'm waiting for the day when I go to Burbank Airport and this six-year-old kid looks at me and goes, "It's the bad drone guy." I can spy on people. Teens fly drones for first time. Now this one I actually liked because it makes me look like a teenager. Now this one's the only one that's photoshopped because there's really only one picture that can go with the headline of drone follows woman home from bar, crashes into her car. So that's that is photoshopped. So that was a real. For once the media didn't use that other picture. But what I'm trying to tell here is that the media, especially here in the United States, has a really big impact on how people see things. And it's always easy to focus on a negative story because that's what sells here in the United States. And that's what also forms public opinion. And everyone in this room has an opportunity to change that by highlighting positive stories and creating positive stories. And through education, we are creating tremendous amount of positive stories. So DJI, in case you don't know DJI, yes, we are currently the leading manufacturer of commercial drones. And thanks to the FAA, we are actually the world's largest aircraft manufacturer. So that's pretty awesome. The FAA has determined that a drone is an aircraft. Therefore, the manufacturer is an aircraft manufacturer. And we got the top spot. So that's pretty cool. But DJI actually started out not as a drone company, but as a flight controller company. So the flight controller is in essence the brain of the drone. And back 10 years ago, when the flight controller was developed, it was a really big box that went into one of those big helicopters, RC helicopters, and it took a team to install that. And over time, technology got better, and flight controllers became smaller, and so it was just a logical way of building a drone around the flight controller. So having said that, our flight controllers have millions of hours of flight experience that we can use to then improve the brain of the drone. But over time, we have developed a variety of different aerial as well as ground stabilization platforms from, you know, bigger machines like the S-1000 that has 8 arms to the very well-known Phantom and Inspire 1. But now recently we've really pushed also to take that stabilization system you have in the sky and also have it on the ground with the Osmo, which is the handheld camera stick. So it's quite fascinating to see how these technologies come about and how they develop into different areas. So enough about the products. Now DJI has really become very global. Headquarters is in Shenzhen, China. And I just got back from there, and it is a different world. It's an exciting world over there. It's really like Silicon Valley on steroids. And so much stuff is coming out of Shenzhen. It's mind-blowing. We here in the United States have offices in the area here in Burbank, where we focus mostly on Hollywood production and TV production style projects. And then up in San Francisco, in the Bay Area, we do the SDK, the software development kit, education, and also business development. So why is DJI the leader in the hardware technology? And it's actually because of the ease of use of the platform, the affordability.